Look, now that the pandemic is coming to an end, thank you to vaccines, you can now fully expect to be attending weddings. Or shoot, yo, maybe you're the lucky one, maybe you're the groom. Look, at the end of the day, whether you're the groom, groomsman, or just attending, looking good at a wedding can be complicated, and I want to make sure that this wedding season, you look like a stud. Let's hop into it. Number one, let's start with the groom. See, if you are the groom, you are the center of attention. It is your day, so I want to make sure you look as good as possible. As long as possible, let me explain. See, if you're a formal or a black tie type of wedding, or that's what you guys are planning, that means you're gonna need probably a tux. From my personal opinion though, I did a formal wedding, I don't recommend it. I do not recommend you buying a tux, and instead I'd rather you get a black suit. See, 2 years ago, I actually bought two tuxes. I had a morning tux and an evening tux. Ask me in the last 2 years how many times I've worn that tux. Zero. They're like in the back of my closet, and now all that money was lost. Instead, what I want you to do is buy a black suit, something sexy, that's powerful and timeless. It's almost as formal as a tux. Most people won't even notice, and the interesting part is that 10 years from now, when you look at your wedding pictures, you're gonna look sharp. But even better, that's a versatile suit that you can wear multiple times throughout your life, even when you're not attending a formal event. So if you ask me if I could do it all over again, I would be buying a black suit over a tux any day. Apart from that, you want to pair that with a white shirt, a black bow tie, and some patent leather shoes or some shiny leather shoes, and you're good to go. You got a timeless look that you're going to be looking good 20 years from now. Number two. Let's say you're a groomsman. See, if you're a groomsman, you should have one rule in mind. You are not there to overdress or look better than the groom. You're there to support your boy. It is your boy's big day, which means you probably have it easy. See, your groom probably is gonna be choosing the suits for you. But if you're the one in charge of choosing suits, go with gray. Bless yourself and bless the rest of the groomsmen. See, gray is that essential first suit every guy needs. When you buy it, not only are you gonna look good at the wedding, not only are you gonna look good 15 years from now when you look back, you're gonna have a suit that you're gonna be wearing over and over and over again, because it's gonna be your most versatile suit. Shoot, gray suits is what like 90% of my closet is. That's what I fill my closet with, like this dark one, because it's so versatile. So if you're there, I want you to go for a dark gray suit. I want you to skip the bow tie, get a nice tie, skip the colorful shirts or colorful socks. Again, I don't want you looking 5 years from now, looking back and thinking how cringy you look. Instead, I want you to look back and think, damn, I looked good. When I look back at my wedding pictures from 2 years, I look back and I'm like, yo, I would still wear this today. You wanna know why? Because it's timeless and the fit is on point. And that there is key. See, the suit fit is everything. That's what's gonna salvage you and make sure that you look your best. And when it comes to suits, you already know, I'm all about suit supply. See, I did a whole video where I showed you different layers of suits, where I showed you a $100 suit, I showed you a mid-tier $500 suit, and then I showed you a high-end $10,000 suit. I recommend you go and watch that video. The point is that at the end of the day, that middle mid-tier suit, it is the best bang for your buck. That is your suit supply. That's why like 80% of my closet is suit supply. That is exactly why I got married in suit supply. The two tuxedos you see, those are from suit supply as well, because I love the fit so much. I am a genuine fan of this brand. So when they came out to me and told me that they wanted to sponsor this video to help you guys look good for a wedding, yo, that was a definitive yes on my part. This is the brand that I know that it's gonna hook you up. See, right now they just dropped their custom program. This is so dope, where in the custom program, you get to design your suit from scratch. This is one of the custom suits that I just went through. The cool part with the custom program is that you could start online, you get access to thousands of different fabrics from Italian and English mills. These are the best of the best fabrics ever. You then get to fully customize your suit like you're seeing. Peak lapels, notch lapels, what color buttons you want. You can even customize the inside, you can put your initials. Like, you have total customization. You feel like a legit designer. For example, I never put belt loops on my trousers, so I designed them with side tab adjusters. All my suits are completely custom. So basically with this new custom program, you get that completely high-end $10,000 experience, but you get it like at a ridiculously low price. Like, this is at a fraction of the price. This is why every time somebody asks me, where should I get a good suit from? It's always suit supply. So if you are in wedding season, you're a groom, groomsman, or you're gonna be attending, or shoot, even if you just need a first suit, I want you to check it out. There's gonna be a special link down below. Go to that link and run through that custom program. Just go through it, design your suit, see what it feels like. Once you do, you can step into any suit supply store. They have hundreds of stores across the nation. And when you go in there, you're gonna be treated by a professional. If you've ever stepped into a suit supply store, you'll see almost every dude there looks like a model and they dress right. Like their style know-how, their style IQ, it's out the roof. So not only are they gonna guide you as to how you should style that suit, they're also gonna measure you to ensure that that suit fits properly. And if it doesn't, they'll do free alterations until it fits like a legit glove, just like they did with this suit. If you boys wanna try out Suit Supply's new custom program, click that link down below. See, if your RSVP is black tie, that's easy. Go for tux, or take my advice, go for something very dark color that you get versatility from. If it's formal, again, simple. Go for a gray colored suit, something that's versatile that you can wear again outside that wedding. If it says casual, this is when you come out to play. This is when you let a little bit of your personality flow and you can put aside those neutral grays or blues and instead pick something rich like olive. For example, that olive dark color is one of my favorite colors for suits because it's just as versatile as gray, but it's a little bit different. It shows a little bit more of your personality. It's a little bit more fun. Now, here is the key. At this point, you can let go of the bow tie, of the tie. You can swap the lace-ups for some loafers and you're good to go. The key here though is, like everything else, you're not trying to steal the spotlight. So if you're going for a colored suit, find something that's a little bit more muted. That way it's not overly bright and you're just calling for attention because that's just bad taste. Which takes us on to number four, and it is suit etiquette. It is incredible to me that till this day, people still don't understand proper suit etiquette. I mean, just look at this guy. This guy's famous. Everybody knows who this guy is. I'm sure he's been in thousands of meetings before. He's worn suits thousands of times and he still is wearing it incorrectly. When you step into a wedding venue, you'll see the same thing. 90% of men don't know how to wear a suit. So let me explain. Most suits have two buttons, which means you're not gonna be using both. You only use that top button. You don't want to button the bottom button because that way you get that perfect inverted triangle that every guy wants. What most guys do is that they button both buttons and now you have that square look like this guy that completely blocks off your silhouette and nobody wants that blocky look. While yes, I know it's counterintuitive, like why is there two buttons and you can't button the bottom one? That's just basic suit etiquette because at the end of the day, it ends up fitting your body better. Moreover, when you're sitting down, I want you to always unbutton your suit because this is relaxing and it allows you to breathe. When you stand up, never walk with your suit unbuttoned and instead always button it up. Again, proper suit etiquette 101. And finally, number five, it's accessories. Now, I am a man of simplicity. It's just practical. I love it because it's easier, it's efficient, and I know 10 years from now, it'll always look good. I won't look back and cringe of how much I was overdoing it. So when it comes to accessories, it's no different. A watch, that's a basic essential. When it comes to a pocket square, if you want to wear one, stick to white. White always looks good and you'll never have to worry about it 20 years from now of it being overly bright or maybe too tacky. And finally, a necklace. If you want to wear a necklace or a ring, again, keep it minimal. Don't start stacking them. Now there is one more accessory that you can add. This is not required, but if your shirt requires cufflinks, definitely go for those cufflinks. That is a power move that I recommend every guy to make that 20 years from now, you'll be looking like a boss. And that's basically it for this week's video, guys. Those are five rules that you want to consider if you'll be attending a wedding this summer. I want you to look good. If you guys like this video and found it informative, don't forget to drop us a like down below. Also, boys, don't forget to check out our sponsor, Suit Supply. They'll be linked down below as well. That's it for me today. See you next time.